Alright, welcome back, yeah, beautiful bastards, to what will be a big execution episode of dealing with these goddamn bastards I've, been dealing with for, 10 episodes, pretty much? Not really, but... Now, it's like, which one should I do first? Man, this one that's closer, yeah, sure, why not, yeah, whatever. Still learning the ropes, even now. I don't know what's going to happen when I take over these districts, if they'll tell me what districts I'm going to give them. I gotta remember it's friggin' Barclay sorry, ran over her head. Barclay for Cassandra, downtown for Vito, and friggin' Tickfall for Burke. Watch me screw that up.
If you're ready to lay hands on...
How did you manage to get to Tony D'Orazio?
I had bugs and wiretaps all over the damn place. When that weirdo left the Royal Hotel to deal with one of his men, I was listening.
Tony, big man.
I didn't know you was coming. I'm just packing away your latest shipment.
How long you been running this business, Joe?
I don't know. 5, 6 years?
5 years, 3 months, and 18 days. This has turned.
Look, I know I've been lying, but it ain't my fault.
I've always placed a premium on maintaining order. If you let the rot set in, eventually it will take hold and destroy everything you've built. The only solution is to isolate it, eradicate it before it takes hold. You understand, Joe?
Christ, Tony, you gotta listen to me. Some nuts out there shooting the hell out of everything. You know how many of my men he killed?
Yes.
Oh! Didn't see that coming. That was a lie.
Dominic, is it? You will take the armored car and personally oversee the collection of all outstanding monies owed to us. Am I clear on this?
Yes, Mr. Razio.
Once you have collected what is due, deliver it directly to me at the hotel. The code to the elevator is 0451.
0451. Okay, write that down.
From there, Lincoln had a couple of options. He could use the elevator code and go into the lobby, which meant shooting the hell out of the place. Or he could steal Dominic's car and go in quiet to the hotel's parking garage.
When you're in the hotel, grab a couple of those little fancy soaps. They won't give me any more at the motel.
Okay. Multiple ways of entry. Excuse me. I have more important things to do than you. I go first. And the law won. I thought the law or the law won.
Trying to get past the midweek. Come out to the French ward.
Yeah, okay. I see that.
That didn't sound right.
Come on over here. That's a dark alleyway. You might be in danger. Come on, just a little closer. Thank you. Now, I will admit, it has been a couple of days.
Let's take
taking so long?
I give it a month.
Give what a month? What are you whispering for?
Might be rusty.
Tony off Dominic.
That's fucked up, man. I give him 6 months. At least.
I know I heard something. Mm-hmm.
No tattletales in my neighborhood. Wait. I will probably need this health. Thank you. And I'll take the money too. Okay. I don't really blend in. I'm not sure if they'll if they'll let me in. There's a lot of stuff here.
Pull on in, Dominic. Park anywhere.
Oh. Okay. You think they would, you know, check? Now the problem is that, you know, I don't have a silent weapon, so once I get noticed, I'm kind of all out.
I was gone for a minute. Tony wouldn't mind. Mr. DeRozio, how long you been here? A month? Mr. DeRozio ain't the second chance. You might just live to see month two.
See, now that guy's gonna be a problem. Okay. Already almost failed? That's great. I'm gonna get that health as well. And this is exactly why I saved these missions for their own thing. Okay. So I can get this health. These are gonna be longer missions, so. Is that just a straight shot up? Why would I need to take the elevator? Didn't he say the elevator would be a loud way to go about it? Just in case. I don't have any armor either. Oh, well, nope, never mind, I do. I'm stupid. Oh. Ooh, Marcano, come on. What the fuck's going on down there? Sit him down.
It would be difficult not to.
What?
I've already taken the appropriate steps to address the situation. Believe me, things are well in hand.
Well, they fucking better be. If this thing with the judge
I'm not wearing that.
Shit's gonna roll downhill real fucking quick.
Doctored footage.
We haven't lost anything of any significance except for some men. And they can be replaced. In fact, they're the easiest thing to replace.
Saul doesn't give two shits about any of those stupid fucks. All he cares about is the people that matter. Understand?
I understand completely. And you have my word that all payments will continue as scheduled. None of our business associates need to concern themselves with our recent difficulties.
Yeah? Okay. I'm counting on you here, Tony. Don't fuck this up.
Goodbye.
Oh, it gave me hell. Oh, and you couldn't even come up this way. Lady, you didn't see anything?
Clear on out of here.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the thing, Congressman. When Mr. D'Orazio made his very generous contribution to your campaign,
Congressman,
it was based on promises about those lots downtown. Well-documented donations. No threat intended, sir. Just a reminder. Will you do that?
We'll Congressman is in on this?
Thanks.
What did them? So, you want to come over this way? And you don't see my big gun sticking out? Okay, that was close. I don't know. Why is this guy walking? Yeah, this. I don't need that.
Cocksucker! God damn!
Oh, no. Ah, come on. You screwed me over again. Ooh, ooh. Look how much health that did me.
My blood's going down.
Guys are so rude.
Fuck! Reload!
Dead fucking oi.
Run out of fight here, boys.
killing me!
Oh, I just did that. Wasn't so hard. I'll take that.
So much blood. Look at all the blood.
Yeah, there's a lot, man.
Done made my goddamn day.
Got him over here.
It's just good business.
Ain't no way you getting past here, boy.
Look who we got here.
Yeah. Grab some cover.
Got nowhere to go.
You put your fingers out again, man. I'll shoot him off.
At that fucking height.
Cover me while I reload.
Can't fucking move.
Fucking hit me.
He's cutting us down. Running for cover.
What did you call me? That is very rude. Okay, you're not dead. Great. Now you're dead. You know, for a stupid bastard, I took down a good couple of districts. Whoops. Threw that.
Follow me.
What? He's fucking still alive.
Take him down.
I'll take that. Need some help. That's unfair, man. Oh, money. Don't mind if I do. I'll take that. Okay, and then heal up. Now we're maxed out for this. Come on. What the hell?
You made quite the mess of my operation.
Well, I would like to say that was hard, but it wasn't. I'll take that. Oh, is that an RPG? Let me test that out. Good. Hey, time for you to die. Chivalry.
You think you know how all this is gonna play out?
Hit that
you?
First shot.
Idiot. Go ahead. Kill me. I'll be replaced tomorrow. No one will even notice.
You're wrong. Everyone will notice.
Oh. Well, Jesus. That's one way to make people notice.
War on the streets of our fair city as a gunman stormed the Royal Hotel, killing an untold number of men.
There was a loud crash, like a bomb going off. I looked up and there was a man falling from the top of the building.
Then all these men showed up and every one of them had a gun. They ran into the Royal and that's when the shooting started.
I still don't know how the hell Lincoln got out of that hotel.
Oh, that's for me to do. Well, great.
No way Tony's still alive.
Hush. Whoever you are, you did real good getting up here. But leaving's gonna be a different story.
Yeah, just come on out now.
We got a bumper for these assholes. Oh, come on.
How, that,
you know, you bunch of fuckwits.
How did you freaking see me? That's a little powerful, don't you think?
He's cutting us down.
Throw in a Molotov.
No, you're not. No, you're not. Freaking saw me from like a freaking 90 degree angle. He was coming up here facing that way, but yet somehow saw me right through that little crack. No, I don't know about that, man. Seems like a little BS to me. Just preparing myself. There's only one way up, it seems, so. Logically, they should have this whole area. Get up and see if he's still in there. Yeah, look at that. Whoop. Whoop.
Take him down. Hey. Hey. Over here.
He's over here. Run.
Hey. Run. I don't think that. Nope. Oh god. I'm on fire, my head. That's not nice. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I'll just be going. Oh, God. I'll never expect to escape by sea.
Look at you. Guess there ain't no turning back now, huh, pal?
This is our first step toward breaking Marcano and taking over the city. I hear what y'all got to say, but I decide who gets the turf, and in the end, my decision is final.
Is this a goddamn joke? Look, I know you knew you're calling the shots, but my guys are working that action as we speak. So where's the fucking question?
From where I'm sitting, it looks like you already got a plan for this part of the city.
This is the first I'm hearing of this shit. So I figured you got your plans worked out, but goddamn, you know how to get these white boys riled up.
Sit down, you've already assigned the rackets in this district, but now you must assign this district to one of your underbosses, and all bets are off. Deciding who will run this district will reassign its rackets to your chosen underboss. Assigning a district to one of your underbosses will unlock more favors and improve the amount of kickback you'll collect while making them more loyal to you. Underbosses might resent not getting a district, which could have consequences down the road, but if you really want to get the most out of any single underboss, you'll need to make the hard choices.
I'm all for making a big statement right out of the gate.
No change, no change. So yeah, it goes to Vito, this is his district. Alright, let me just...
You need to show me you serious about working together. So far, I ain't seen shit.
Gonna need Vito to run this turf.
About fucking time. Always knew you had a good head on your shoulders.
I'll bite my tongue and keep my eyes on the next part of the city. We good, brother. For now.
As for me, I'll be biding my time and waiting for one of you assholes to fuck up. Fair warning.
We're done for now. You'll hear from me if I need you.
This part is done. Pretty easy. At least I don't have to assign all three districts at the same time.
Police are intensifying their search for the colored male believed to be responsible for the massacre at the Royal Hotel. The suspect is described as 6'3" and is believed
They're
to be
saying
armed.
You threw Tony off the roof of the Royal?
Actually, it was through his penthouse window.
You always had a flair for the dramatic.
Tony's ledger. Last couple pages are pretty interesting.
Any idea what US5CJ means? Wait a minute. Holy shit. Why is Lou willing to comp 10 grand a month at a brothel and the same at a drug den?
Based on what Greco told me in Scaletta, Marcano's laying out a bunch of money to get gambling legalized. And if that's what you're after, who better to have in your pocket?
Than a judge on the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals, US5CJ.
Exactly.
There have to be over 20 judges on that bench. Could be any one of them.
The kind of man we're talking about isn't used to people getting into his business. I start visiting the places listed in that ledger, he'll panic and go to Lou for help.
And that's when we'll find out who he is.
Keep that wiretap running.
Never turn it off.
Talk to Father James. Disposable Negroes. Am I allowed to say that? I'm sorry if I wasn't. Sorry. It's time to take out the... It's Uncle Lou Marcano. Okay. Not only is Lou the beloved unofficial mayor of the French ward, he also brings in massive amounts of profit and has invaluable political connections across the city.
Oh, hell.
Drugs! Sex! Yeah, sex! Okay. Okay, no, this is, yeah, this is like, we're not gonna do that yet, okay. One step at a time. I do need to go and talk to Father, but how am I gonna do that when I have to talk to him there? That makes no sense. How am I gonna meet him, but then not talk to him? Or Father James, Robert, whatever. Let's do this mission. Not in my outfit, as usual. Let's hope I can fit this mission in.
Kakadao! Kakadao! Jesus Christ. I'm gonna shot you in the goddamn face.
Now we're even.
Fucking asshole.
Time to call Enzo.
Alright. Dial this. Yeah.
Barclay Mills is gone. All of it.
Who the fuck is this?
Take a guess.
Got a lot of nerve calling me like this. You know who the fuck I am?
I know exactly who you are, Enzo.
You're a mob lieutenant who's just lost control of his district. Marcano will probably end up playing you next to Michael Greco.
You goddamn coward. You want me dead? Be a man. Do it yourself.
I don't want you dead, Enzo. I want to make a deal.
Jesus Christ, son. You need to get your fucking head examined.
You tell me who's behind the construction of Marcano's casino, and I'll do what I can to keep that wop asshole from killing you.
Why the fuck should I think you could protect me from Marcano?
Look at what I did to you.
Meet me at the quarry.
Next time, don't let me catch you napping.
Kiss my ass.
I knew this would take place at the quarry. It was so hard to get into. To get that with a friggin' last Vargas or whatever. And I'm sure we're gonna talk to Enzo. It'll be very talkative.
Hey, I'll get her out to you right away.
Can I make the air quotes any more exaggerated? Okay.
One car is promised.
Appreciate it.
Prominent local businessman Anthony D'Orazio was murdered today when an unknown suspect stormed his residence at the Royal Hotel. Witnesses at the scene saw D'Orazio fall from the window of his penthouse apartment.
There was a loud crash, like a bomb going off. I looked up and there was a man falling from the top of the building.
Police have declined to say whether or not they have any leads or a name for the suspect in the case.
Starting off great already. I have faith that I can do this. Let me just get this health. There's some explosives here. And everything. So that's already a great sign that everything here is going to go smoothly because we're just going to talk to Enzo. Hello, Enzo. You ready to talk?
Hey,
Put the gun away.
If I wanted you dead, Enzo, I wouldn't have walked through the front door.
All the same, I ain't taking no chances. Hold on here. I know you. You're Lincoln Clay, right? Lived with Sammy Robinson? Went off to NAMM?
That's right.
Christ, son, if I'd have known that, we could have saved ourselves a whole lot of trouble. Follow me.
Oh no, we're gonna have to defend
you
it.
You probably don't know this, but Sammy and I went way back. He was a good man. Didn't deserve what happened to him. Hell, none of y'all did. And this shit with the casino, it's a giant fuck you from Sal to every man who ever worked for him. He wants to go legit and fuck the rest of us in the process. Guess it's well past time I fucked him back.
Oh?
You know Remy Duval?
Sure, he's the big shot on the radio.
The racist.
Without him, there's no casino. He owns the land, runs a construction company, you name it.
So, these are all fronts?
Yeah, they're bullshit. Created a big paper trail to protect himself in case everything falls apart.
And Marcano doesn't own any of the land?
Nah, it all belongs to Duval. He's no idiot. Long as it's in his name, Sal can't touch him.
How do I find him?
He lives up in Frisco Fields. But from what I hear, Olivia Marcano is keeping close tabs on him, forcing him to stay low. Last thing Sal needs is for his sole legitimate partner to get into trouble.
We should get moving.
Looks like it's a little late for that.
Well, of course this was gonna happen.
I don't know when I'm stuck
Let's
in
go.
Prison, and time keeps dragging on.
Go, John Cage.
I was just a baby. My mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry.
Can't move!
God.
I bet there's rich folk from a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free.
And it's a little up. Oh, nope, that's not one. How am I supposed to do that? Jesus Christ. Move the camera for me. My God, there's some voodoo. There's some voodoo going on, man. Game's cheating me every turn.
Bust out of
explosives in a couple of spots I got round the quarry. No way I'm just walking away and leaving all this to die. Right there's right. The first batch.
Let me get one up this there, move on to the rest. Okay.
You weren't kidding about these explosives.
That's voodoo, man. Voodoo.
Back in the day, we tried sticking our peckers in the ground and fucking the stone out. But all we ended up with was chapped nutsacks.
Yeah, you know, I didn't even know that. What the heck? How do I get up there? It would be through here, wouldn't it? No. Oh, I'm stupid. I mean, has that ever not been the case?
Got it.
They teach you that in the army?
Nope. Sunday school.
Back in the day, I'd have been out there fighting alongside of you.
Or going up against me. Would turn
on us. That wouldn't have been good for you, son.
You got money? No, but you got ammo, that's better. No, you don't. It's always good to set off explosives when you're setting explosives up to explode places. Probably should not be by those explosives.
If you consider shithole rice patties beautiful, grab a one-way ticket. But for me, it don't get ugly.
Oh my god, come on, fire. That's rude. So rude. Once again, send off explosives right next to explosives. That's good. Nothing wrong with that, Morton. Nothing wrong with that. More explosives. Good. Fire coming down. No, thank you.
Fucking stuck in a man's life. Don't get more personal than that, cocksucker.
Get him down.
Yeah. God damn it. Can't move.
Come on out, Enzo. I'm doing quick. Won't hurt enough. I said the same.
Dropping like fucking flies. Grab and cover. Hey, he's over here.
Excuse me. Oh, I know you're in. Okay. Sorry, I thought you were an enemy. Trying to infiltrate me. Whoop. My God, I almost destroyed my car. Okay. We're good. Now, Enzo, you gonna hop in my car or do you have one?
Some of these men work for you.
Not some of them, all of them.
That should do it.
Car's through here.
Of course you have a car. What about my car, man?
God damn.
You like?
No, I love.
And I'll never drive it.
Make a financial contribution to your cause. They got it blocked, but I bet we can bust through the gate.
What about the train tunnel?
The tunnel? It's your call.
Well, we're gonna go through the train tunnel.
All aboard! Fuck you, you goddamn cockroaches!
Stand the heat.
And so the car.
I am the cockroach. King cockroach.
Enzo, calm down, man. They can't even hear you.
Fuck them in the eye.
I wouldn't do that yet. That sounds unsanitary. Just slow down. Let him catch up. They're very professional. Okay.
I got this girl, Henrietta. Shacks up at the Carousel Hotel in the Hollow. Smart as a fucking whip. I left a fucking bag with her. Should have all I need to get by.
Two tears in a bucket.
You know Sammy was proud as hell of you, right? Not just for the wartime shit, but for the way you fought through life before you came to him. How you watched over Ellis. And how you helped with Perla when she was sick. He admired you. And don't you ever forget it. Fucking Sal ain't half the man Sammy was.
But yet he has all of what Sammy had. In terms of, you know, land and stuff, you know. That's what I meant. Not even sure if it works then either. But shut up.
This is good right here. Sorry again about what happened to Sammy and Ellis.
Appreciate it.
This district will go to Cassandra.
There you are. Pull up a seat. Let's get cracking.
Turns out there's at least one sane motherfucker in Marcano's crew. Enzo Conti backed away clean. No one's moving anything through Barclay Mills without paying up to us.
Time for me to run something more than a holler, brother. You got us secure in the district. I see no reason we shouldn't remain there.
To say I'm biding my time would be a fucking understatement. I got no idea where your mind's at, but my patience is running short.
We're on a good run here, Lincoln. I see no reason anything should change. Now, not using my guys to lock down a district makes it real fucking messy if you want us to run shit, but hell, you pay me to clean up the mess.
The two of us, we're not escaping each other. Might as well embrace it.
Sounded
to run this part of the city.
This ought to fit real nice with what we already got going in the holler. Sends the right message to our people as well.
Is this over? Because I really need to go drop a load in the bog.
I'm going to call this if no one else will.
Time to get back at it. Let's clear out.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. What a prick.
Turns out you were right.
I gotta go. Thank you for this.
Happy hunting, Donovan.
Miss Lancaster's helping me with a side project. You get a name at Enzo?
Yeah, Remy Duval. He's not only building the casino, he also owns all the land where it's being built.
Remy Duval? The jackass on the radio?
Yep.
His family's been down here a couple hundred years. Thinks it makes him everyone's massa.
According to this, he heads up the Southern Union in his spare time.
The Southern Union's basically the fucking Klan.
No, he said it wasn't.
Right before I shipped out, Father James was with some other folks protesting the fact that the city didn't have any black cops. Southern Union came in and kicked the shit out of everybody they could get their hands on. Day after, they spray painted "God hates niggers" across the front of his church.
If President Andrew Johnson had actually executed those traitorous fucks, we wouldn't have this goddamn problem.
Enzo also mentioned Olivia Marcano.
Olivia's an outlier. Old Southern money. She's the one that was married to Sal's brother, Lucho. At least until someone slit his throat.
And she runs Frisco Fields.
Ever since Lucho died. She expanded his drug business and opened a PCP lab. Since a lot of mafiosos live up there, she probably just has a place they can socialize.
Well, it's usually in the back of some business.
I never knew the mob had women as capos.
She's there to keep Duval in line. Only people these entitled pricks listen to are other entitled pricks.
So who are you gonna go after first?
Duval. Since he owns the land where the show is being built, killing him will muddy things up.
You think hitting Olivia's businesses will help draw him out?
I've known racist assholes like him my entire life. Black man like me running around terrorizing white folks. He ain't gonna be able to let that stand. His pride will bring him down.
Hey, you know that bourbon's not cheap. Good luck out there.
Bro, it tasted so good, I bet. Frisco Fields. Okay.
Sending some new wheels to Delray Hollow.
Aye, I'll get her out to you right away.
So yeah, that means in the next episode, you didn't drive all the way around that town. That was great. Thank you.
Got
be there soon.
Next episode, we take down Frank.
All right. What are we handling?
And then we start up
better not lose this.
All the other district missions, including the sixth mission. But
how y'all doing out there?
Oh, you know,
got something to speak about. So open up your ears and get ready to receive. This time we gonna discuss our governance.
This is gonna take forever.
What are you doing for you? paving the roads, keeping the mill running, protecting and serving. Your answer probably depends on who you are, where you live, and the shade of your skin. But right now, we're gonna be discussing one specific organization operating with the full support of our current administration. And that is the FBI. Turns out those motherfuckers are doing everything possible to undermine the black voice and the black vote. Even going so far as to target our black leaders. And who you think they consider to be the most dangerous black leader? Try Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. May he rest in peace. After Dr. King gave his I Have a Dream speech in 1963, the FBI labeled him, and I quote, the most dangerous and effective Negro leader in the country. Our federal government labeled a man who preached only peace dangerous. A man who spoke on hope, hard work, and dedication was now considered a threat. And the FBI proceeded to track his every move until this past April, when he was murdered outside a Memphis motel. What was that? You don't believe me? The U.S. government wouldn't allow one of their own agencies to do something so horrible, you say? Why don't you ask our fellow Americans of Japanese heritage what they think our government's capable of? The ones rounded up like cattle in the internment camps right here on American soil during World War II. Try asking our Indian brothers and sisters fighting for their survival on the very land stolen out from under what they think our government's capable of. Shit, ask the fucking Kennedys. But why would the FBI do something like
that? Oh, goddamn it. I'm sorry, but we're awfully goddamn tight right now on time, so I hate to cut that off because that was very good, what he was saying. I liked it. Anyway, whatever. I hope you enjoyed this episode, you beautiful bastards. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.